colors by our own Salem County Vocational Technical School ROTC. Stand.
Commodore, Gary Toth. Forward, march.
Can we bow our heads for a prayer?
And before we pray, I just want to especially heavy on our heart for all of Salem County that we've lost the Marine Corporal Kearns. Tomorrow, the funeral service will be they'll be bringing him from Dover to Salem County. So at the end of the prayer, I'd like to have a moment of silence for, we all can pray for their family and for their well-being.
Do you know the service will be?
I do. I think tomorrow will be 4 to 7, I believe, and then there will be at Layton's, and on Friday. The next day will be at Sharptown Methodist, and then determine at 11 o'clock. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for this day. We thank you for these people that are attending. We want to thank you for Salem County and the beauty and the Lord, just for the gift of this county. We ask you to be with this meeting tonight. May the words and our actions be acceptable unto you. May we look to you for guidance in all that we do and say. So we ask you to be with the family of Marine Corporal Kearns. You may be with them, guide them, keep them safe, keep them comforted. We ask them just to be in your lap and just care for them. And now as we all pray in our own special way. And as all God's people say, amen.
Amen.
Deputy Director Laurie.
Here.
Freeholder Cross.
Present.
Freeholder Vanislav.
Here.
Freeholder Ware is out of town. Freeholder Bobbitt.
Here.
Freeholder Timmerman.
Present.
Director Abbott.
Here.
Director, you have 6 freeholders present in this council meeting.
Minutes, please.
I'd like to make a motion to dispense with reading of the minutes of the April 4th meeting. Minutes are to be received, approved, and reported in the minute book.
I'll second that motion.
I have a motion second. All in favor, please raise your right hand. Waiver of the rules.
Director, we have a waiver of the rules for items number 4 and number 5.
Make a motion that we have a waiver of the rules for resolutions 4 and 5.
So moved.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please raise your right hand. Opposed? Special recognition.
We have a proclamation to commend Salem County Municipal Alliance Committee Coalition. Deputy Director.
Yes, you got Brenda. This is a proclamation to commend the Salem County Municipal Alliance Committee Coalition. Municipal Alliance is for substance abuse. I do want to read a couple items on here. Salem County MAPSA membership includes a total of 140 volunteers. Salem County MAPSA together serviced 10,926 participants of all ages with a total of 670 volunteers helping, providing 2,180 free volunteer hours to implement, sponsor, and host presentation, education, and activities. That's wonderful. The volunteerism in this county is alive and well. I mean, with you guys, with the search right on down, it's just a great thing that this county does, is volunteer. And we're grateful for it, and I'd like to make this presentation to... Okay. Do you have anything you want to say?
Well, just as chairperson of the County Municipal Alliance Steering Committee, I wanted to thank the Freeholder Board for the recognition because the many, many, as you said, many, many hours of volunteer work that Municipal Alliances do has an impact on our youth of today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ray, could you introduce another set of your names?
I don't know all the members, but Brenda does.
Okay. Brenda.
I'm testing my memory here. We have Amy Martin from Palsgrove Woodstown. We have Cindy Schimpf from Mannington and Jolynn Beal from Mannington. Here we go. And we have Mr. Witt from Alloway. And they're here tonight to present all the municipal licenses. Obviously, the municipal licenses are either in a meeting or other plans with their families, or they may be participating in the program. The one thing that I want to mention with your numbers that we have reached out, over 10,000, that's unduplicated. So these, you know, programs really do serve so many more than that. If you take every single time that a youth comes out to a program or a senior comes out to a program or a parent. So when we really look at those numbers, that's unduplicated. I just wanted to point that out. And the hours are 2,000. And what I must say is these are volunteers. They are grassroots. In the community, plan and prevention programs. The new state logo from our Governor's Council on Alcoholism and Drug Abuse, their new logo is, doesn't get any more local. And I really think that that says a lot about the Municipal Alliance program. So I thank you for commending our Municipal Alliances on behalf of all the volunteers. Thank you. And this is National Volunteer Week of the National Volunteer Month. So thank you.
Still are involved with the monthly child safety seat program.
And then we have the New Jersey Shares, the piggybacks along with the Vita throughout the year. All I can say is thank you for your support. Thank you to the constituents, who I'm sure some are here in the building, and those that gave their time and their energies.
Tim, what are some ways for these folks to volunteer?
The basics that we have are, again, during the beginning of this holiday season, once we get into the campaigns starting August, but as we get into the end of the summer, there's plenty of ways that these folks can help us with preparing holiday gift baskets, being able to let us know what's available on those lines to help us contact families, help us keep track internally of those folks, and be able to just meet the basic needs of the folks that come to our door.
And I know I'm part of the reading program at John Fennell School, and kids love to read to it.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Thank you.
Okay, well, thank you very much for your
Yes. Madam Director, if I could, could you clarify for the folks in the room and Freeholder Board as well, are you still eligible to donate through payroll to the United Way?
Absolutely. That is a major part of what we call a campaign.
Okay.
Yes, thank you.
Any other Freeholder questions? Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bond ordinance providing for the undertaking of the 2012 capital improvements at and for certain facilities at Salem Community College, located within the county of Salem, state of New Jersey, appropriating $2,100,000. Need a motion for the introduction on first reading.
I'd like to make that motion for the first reading. I'll second.
I have a motion second. Roll call, please.
Deputy Director Lahr.
Yes.
Senator Cross?
Yes.
Senator Vanslyke?
Yes.
Senator Bobbitt?
Yes.
Senator Timmerman?
Yes.
Director Acker?
Yes.
You have 6-4-0 against for the introduction of Ordinance 2012-003, public hearing and adoption is scheduled for Wednesday, May 2nd, 2012.
Very good. I see President Bailey is here. Would you like to make any comments? And thank you for coming out. I see a lot of your staff and board members here. It's great to see you. Don't be strangers. Come anytime.
Well, we're very happy to hear what's going on this evening, and we hope that we hear the same thing on May 2nd. And you can see from the folks here from the college that these improvements are desperately needed at the institution. And, you know, we look forward to hearing the result on May 2nd.
Thank you.
Very good. Thank you. Okay,
can I make
a comment? Yes. Yeah, the only thing I'd like to comment on is perhaps we could, while we're looking at this, maybe look at the improvement authority as far as bonding. Maybe save some costs down the road. I think it's worth looking at refinancing gas and glass. Things are important. Food and thought, I thought it might be just an option to look at, maybe save some costs.
Thank you. For those who do not want to stay, feel free to go ahead and go. You won't be offended.
Washington. Resolution amending Salem County Policy and Procedure Manual Resolution requesting an extension of time for the 2012 budget introduction waiver required under the May 16th. Resolution appointing legal counsel for specific human resources related matters to the county of Salem and executing a professional services contract in the amount not to exceed $4,500 to Ellen M. Horn, Esquire of Ruben and Glickman, waiver required.
You heard the reading of the five resolutions. What's your pleasure?
Move for adoption.
Second. I have a motion, second. Any discussion? Yes.
Madam Director, if I could point out on resolution number two, that this is a renegotiation of the fees. We've lowered the contract and brings us in line with the line item and takes them through September, and hopefully we'll have some results that substantial.
Very good. We always like to hear that saving money. Any other discussion? Hearing none. All in favor, please raise your right hand. Opposed? Motion carries. Health Committee, please.
Resolution authorizing Freeholder Director and Clerk of the Board of Social Freeholders to the County of Salem to sign and accept the 2012 County Environmental Compact Grant Application.
Make a motion to approve the resolution.
Second.
I have a motion and second. Any discussion? Hearing none. All in favor, please raise your hand. Opposed? Motion carries. Social Services Committee, please.
Resolution authorizing contract with the administration of the grant administration of the Alliance to Prevent Alcoholism and Drug Abuse for the year 2012.
Madam Director, I move the resolution.
I'll second it.
Motion and second. Any discussion? Hearing none. All in favor, please raise your hand. Opposed? Motion carries. Public Safety Committee.
Resolution of the Board of Social Freeholders supporting an application in the New Jersey Division of Highway Traffic Safety for a grant for the Salem County Prosecutor's Office Safe Roadways Project.
You heard the resolution. What's your pleasure?
Madam Director, I move that we adopt this one resolution.
Second.
Motion and second. Any discussion? Hearing none. All in favor, please raise your right hand. Opposed? Motion carries. Public Works.
We have a resolution amending a contract for professional engineering services for the County of Salem, James McKelvey, Lima Group, and a resolution awarding a contract providing lawn maintenance services for various property owned by the County of Salem not to exceed $27,520 awarded to JB's Landscaping.
I make a motion that these resolutions number 9 and number 10 be passed.
Second.
I have a motion second. Any discussion? Yes.
On the lawn maintenance services, while we could not award it because we're not a little bitter, someone from this county, these people from Paulsboro, these people brought it back into the state this year. So we're providing money back into the state. Hopefully the next year we can work some money from Salem County.
Any other discussion? All in favor, please raise your right hand. Opposed? Motion carried. Old business?
Madam Director, I'd like to make a motion that we release and submit the layoff plan to the state of New Jersey.
I have a motion second. Any discussion, please?
Well, I haven't seen the layoff plan. It's the same.
It's the one that we put on.
Still with the CWA?
Yes.
Now, what does that mean, submit to the state? What does that mean? You trying to agree with them?
It means that we just are putting the process, we're moving the process forward just in case
my point is, I don't agree with all CWA employees. We're talking about across the board. And I'm not going to vote on this if that's
easy. The plan is being released as was written, however, to amend the plan, which would obviously be done before we acted on it. To amend it or even remove it is relatively easy, but it needs to be released in case there needs to be a layoff so that it can be done in the proper time frame if that ever becomes a need to lay off people. We obviously are going to try not to. That is our main goal, and our overriding goal is that to happen. But in case it needs to be in process, otherwise the plan goes further and further down the road, and we lose those benefits of saving money.
If this layoff plan is amended, can it be amended to subtract or add?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, it may.
Well,
but we have to start the process.
My point is, I'm not in favor of laying these folks off. Now, Once this process starts, then, I mean, you say you
can... You can withdraw from the state, but if we don't start the process takes 30 days, correct me if I'm wrong, see if that, 30 days, 69 days. So every week that goes by, we're just delaying.
So moving forward with this, it appears that these are the folks who are going to make all that. How would, and you say you just change that anytime you're ready, or I mean...
We can amend it.
My director, my office, the state also has the right to amend it. I mean, yes. This is just the first step of the protocol that you have to do in order to submit the plan. It goes up to the state can look and either amend, approve, or disapprove, send it back to us, and then at that point,
so I want to move forward with it. I don't want to take that step saying that I approve this layoff plan because I don't. So if I won't be voting for it.
My concern with sending that, it sends a message to the employees that we've given up on them. We've given up on any other call savings. And I know that you've met with the other unions, but it sort of is giving the other unions an out because the plan is being sent up to the state. It doesn't include anybody but CWA. And it's basically sending a message to these people who are looking for another job. That point is larger.
As I said, it's easily amended. And that would be the plan to amend it. We need to get something started so we get to 69. If we wait till the next board meeting, it's two more weeks. You know, at some point, we at least have to put it in play. We need to take it back. It's just a matter of saying we take it back. Or just we need to amend it to add other, not just the CWA, which, you know, we want to add, you know, try to keep the pain across the board.
Yes.
And I think when we were at this point in March, it was approved and we were going to submit it. And obviously, when we had the issue with the budget, we had a temporary put it on hold. But I think even if we submitted it at that time, fellow pre-orders, we were looking at a July 1st implementation. So now we are, however long it's taken to get to this point, we've added that much time and there won't be any. Theoretically, and I mean, I think it's easy to say that all seven of us, and I'll speak for Freeholder Warriors, not here this evening, it's the last possible step in order to balance the budget. You've all agreed upon that. But this is just the first part of the protocol that the state has sent down and said we have to submit this. And that starts the time frame moving forward.
Yeah, and I appreciate that, Freeholder. But we've had that time of 60 or 90 days that we could have changed it to go across the board with the layoff plan, but we've not done that, so...
Well, we're in negotiation with the unions.
I've already had discussions, and Carol's here. I've explained to them also that it's going to be released and that it's the same one before, but I've also explained to the CWA that this can be amended easily, and essentially what we're assuming, we don't even need it. Something, you know, to advance the timeline, we have to get something up to the state. So if there are good urges to that, we'll have to wait another month for relative use.
That's my point. If we were going to amend it, why haven't we amended it to this point?
Well, we were in negotiations, and we still are. Negotiations are taking longer than needed. Not needed, they're necessary to go this long, but longer than expected.
And what happens is the unions don't meet every week. So we're waiting for their timelines. We're dealing with nine unions. Salem County has nine unions, and not everyone meets weekly. So we've met with all nine unions in the same room, president. Any other discussion? Roll call? Roll call, please.
Deputy Director Barr?
Yes.
Fred Cross?
Yes.
Fred Van Slyke?
Yes.
Fred Bobbitt?
No.
Fred Timmerman?
No.
Director Acker?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-2.
Old business? Anybody else with old business? New business?
Madam Director, if I could just make a comment about the budget process.
Yes.
I have to say that the budget process has been quite challenging and it's even become more challenging with some of the obstacles that have been put in our way. Just one that I want to information that is out there in the public. And that was a letter to the editor that that basically talked about the retirement-related trust fund. And I just want to clarify that it is not a retirement-related trust fund. In that letter, it also stated that it was mandated by the state to fund this trust. And so after some research, we looked at the New Jersey statute under NJAC 5:30-15.5, under accounting for compensated absence funds, a county or municipality may, not must, but may, appropriate and reserve funds for the purpose of compensating employees for accumulated absence time in accordance with the following. And then it goes on to say that nothing in this section shall require any amount, any specific amount, to be appropriated in any given year. It then goes on to say that once the funds are appropriated, funds so reserved for compensated absence shall not be used for any other purpose unless so approved by the local finance board. We have done extensive research and have determined that the fund is excessively funded. And we therefore, and I believe today, our CFO delivered to the local finance board a request to go on their agenda on May the 9th to see, May 9th?
8th.
May 8th, sorry, May 8th, to see if we could release some of that funding, which will help close the budget gap that we're facing. Now, I just want to make sure that we all understand something here. If you're going to put information out there, it should be 100% correct. It's time that we stop bickering back and forth about the details and get this job done. We've been playing on this playing around this budget for way too long. Thank you.
Yes, very well.
So this account is overfunded.
It's overfunded in the estimates that we have. What we're looking at right now is we're going to go back 5 years, and then we're going to do a pro forma projection 5 years out. But it looks to me like we have about $700,000 too much, or it's overfunded by $700,000. And the CFO, correct me if I'm wrong.
It's overfunded by over $1 million. The way we've projected over the years, we treated everyone as if they were vested. The way the rules are written, you do not receive sick pay unless you retire through the pension system. When we do the projections, as we've done the projections every year, at year end, it's projected that every single employee would be eligible to retire through the pension system. When you actually go back and look at who was vested at the end of 2011, the total amount that was needed if every one of those people retired, and every employee in the county took the vacation pay that they were owed, the amount would be under $600,000. Currently, there's $1.7 million sitting in the account.
Thank you.
When we have our auditors come in, this is something that they
picked up. Let me be clear about this. I'm not, as I stated before, I think it's last year will be, I'm not interested in dipping into any of these funds. But on the other hand, if this is overfunded and we use that money, I'm on board.
The same guys.
I'm on board.
And I'm only reading this statement to clarify some misinformation that was put out there by another freedom.
As long as it's overfunded, and we can take those extra money to end this. Absolutely.
Thanks
for
your
time.
Thank you. No, I just think it's fine. Any other new business? And again, I thank everyone for coming out. I enjoy seeing these faces and comments. Sometimes we can't fix anything that it's broken or we don't know what's on your mind. So we really thank you for coming out. Freeholder Cross?
Madam Director, I think it is important. All the things that we talk about here tonight, all the things we talked about in the workshop upstairs, looking at insurance coverages and everything else in order to save money. This is just yet another example. And the concessions that we spoke of, each and every one of those, and we assure you, I think it's important to know that each and every one of these money savings that we have will be funneled strictly to save jobs, period.
Thank you.
And we're not looking at trying to fill gaps within our budget. It is strictly for avoiding that layoff plan that had to be submitted for clarification.
Thank you. That was very good.
Just a public announcement. Wednesday, May 9th, Salem County Clerk is sponsoring the 4th Annual Good Samaritan Awards right here at the courthouse. And we encourage you all to be here, groups, churches, organizations, individuals can submit the names of persons with devoted time and to serve others. So we get to see you all May 9th. And if you have somebody in mind, certainly contact Jilla, our county clerk. Debbie, do you have something happening tomorrow?
I think it goes to that 10. I'm seeing just a message. Beth and I are representing the Freeholder. Now it's time for a public comment. If anybody would like to come up, state your name and address for the record. Yes. I have been spending quite a bit of time together, and I appreciate her efforts. She's a great leader, and she represents our union well.
You're welcome, Donna.
Yes.
Been around real well. I'm Carolyn Shoemaker, Vice President of CWA. I just wanted to say that on behalf of the members that we are still upset about, you know, this is still going to be put in to the civil service for layoffs, being it's still going to be just our group. I know we talked about it, where it can be rescinded and so forth and so on, but the problem is in the past practice that certain things, we've been told certain things in the past, and we took the people at their word on some of this stuff, and it didn't come out to play. So you can understand why people are not very cautious of what people say, especially now more than ever when it comes to these people's jobs. And to say the least, you know, this time is that these people are very upset. And some of the people that were on that list, which I kind of figured them out, more or less, that some of these people have been with the county for quite a few years also. I mean, these weren't people that just walked in the door and say, you know, first one, last one in, first one out. Some of them have been here for quite a few years. And I, you know, I just wanted to make sure that, and I know we have been talking, Julie and I, and the union's trying to come up with a applicable solution that would be fine for both parties, and I hope and pray that we do come to that solution, because more than ever I do not want to see any more layoffs. Most of the departments in this county already are running short-handed, and some of the people are already getting burned out trying to keep up with the pace and try to keep up with all the time limits that we have to do to get jobs done. So I hope, you know, we keep that all in mind. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening. Good evening. Ann Sullivan, Alloway, Woodstown Road in Alloway. First of all, I wanted to thank everyone for working so hard on budget. I attended a lot of those meetings, and they were really fun, some of those Saturday mornings. And especially Mr. Wright, he's lost a lot of weight, and he keeps losing weight. So I'm very concerned about our CFO. He's losing weight, and he's working really hard. So I appreciate whatever he's doing. He's very thin, Saturday. I have a couple of questions on the amendments that were made. Number one, does the amendment resolving the amended resolution 2012-33 for the appointment of the member of the SCIA, does that change the new appointee?
What happened was the new appointee, the term was, it's a 5-year term versus a 4-year term. So it should have read 5 years.
Okay. So it's still the same appointee?
Yes.
Okay, and the same thing about amending
Item number nine, amending the contract for James McKelvey and Lamo Group. What was amended there?
Repeat that question, please.
We're talking number nine, page two, the resolution changing the engineer professional contract. What's being amended?
I believe it's Albert and Dave. Was the annual county aid previously on $4,000, now not exceed $30,000, in 2012 engineering technical assistance to the planning and transportation committee previously $50,000, now will not exceed $25,000.
So it was just the finances?
Yes, and our engineer actually took a cut this year to help out with the budget.
So we're still having Mr. McKelvey?
Yes.
That's wonderful, thank you very much, I appreciate that. Yes.
My name is Jim Brown from 34 Manhattan, Yorktown Ridge in Manhattan. I see that seems to be a fix for this layoff, but my question is that the people that I saw that were getting laid off at the CWA, their salaries were like $24,000, $23,000, and so forth and so on. And I just heard that there's one supervisor that's not taking a raise. Is other supervisors, are they in this?
This will affect pretty much everyone across the board in some one way, shape, or form. We are in negotiations. We're letting kind of the unions take the lead on this, and then we'll go back to our non-union people and with similar suggestions, similar values.
So in other words, to understand this, you're going to the unions first, but you're still going to go to supervisors and non-union people.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
I want to clarify something, getting the microphone. I think the information that went out to, I don't know if it was the newspaper, but people have seen the layoff positions and head. That wasn't clear in the directions, that is not the salary for a year. That was going to be, I believe, the projected savings for half a year in our budget.
Okay,
so a lot of people are looking at how low those salaries are and thinking somebody's going to get paid off and only makes, you know, $15,000 a year. But really, that was just for a half year of savings. So, you know, I've heard this several times now, and I know that people are confused, and we understood it, but unfortunately, the paper didn't say that, so.
Right, I was confused, because I was saying that people that are only making $23,000 are the ones that are given back,
right,
or whatever.
Right.
And okay, so that's
just for saving. Thank you very much.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Yes.
Warren Wheaton, 36,000 Mill Road, Alloway, New Jersey. Just have to talk about this bond ordinance providing for capital improvements at Salem Community College. I'm an high school degree. That's 10 years ago. I work all day, school all night. Seemed like all day. This bond capital improvement is for leaky roof and climate control. I can't tell you how many people quit in the 10 years that I was attending. It's tough enough as it is, without going into a building that probably wouldn't even pass OSHA. I mean, you've got leaky roof, you got temperatures through the roof. You've got to take care of our kids. You know, we're concerned about people with union cards. These people are going to school to get their union card. I got out with a Bachelor of Science in Chemistry. That's my union card. So I'm a union guy and person who is in these unions that are complaining. This is life. I've lived through a bunch of layoffs. It's part of life.
Thank you.
Please, put the roof over their head.
Thank you very much. Yes, Freeholder.
I want to thank Lee and a few of the other constituents in Salem County. They're serving on the Salem County Waterways Advisory Board with Beth, and we've met again, and it's been eyes wide open on this and what's going on with our roadways. And in the future, maybe even the roundtable, we'll be bringing up some discussion for what we can do in Salem County. Thank you very much, Lee, for serving on that and bringing that to us.
Thank you.
Any other public comment? Yes.
Hello to the Freeholders. I'm Judy McNeil, a registered nurse from the Salem County Health Department. Nobody wants to bring this up, but I do. The health department is already 10 people short of trained personnel should we have a natural or a man-made disaster. Any more people getting laid off will be walking a fine line to protect the Salem County residents. And we can't always count on all the volunteers. They may not be able to show up. Also, second, I want to bring up that in talking to the employees, they would rather have furlough days than increase in our health benefits. Thank you.
Thank you, Judy. Anyone else? Yes.
In Jersey, I'm walking slow. Maggie Maxwell Mood, Waterworks Roads, Quinton, New Jersey. Thank you guys. I'm very proud of all of you. You sounded great this evening, and I like the fact that you're giving and taking and working well together as of this moment in time. In any event, I just left the Main Street Day meeting before I came here, so I apologize for barging in late. The day will be August 25th. The rain date will be August 26th. So it's really very important for you guys to support this. They're going to again have vendors, food. I'm in charge of getting the artisans together and having tables and everything for those folks. If in fact some of you guys are business folks, you'd like to make a little donation that way, that would be wonderful. Hint, hint. The other element is over the weekend, I sent a bunch of grant opportunities your way, and I was talking to Blanche. One of them was $1 million floor for improving county health departments, for strengthening that health department. So if you guys haven't sent it to her, please do so, because she wants it, and she wants to get it applied for. It's a win-win for everything. And I'm going to keep sending you grants, whether you like it or not. That's how I am. So thank you kindly, and I appreciate it.
If there's no other public comment, actually, we have a resolution.
We have a written resolution directly resulting in our closed session. We need a motion to approve the William Cobb settlement in the amount of $14,600.25.
So moved.
I have a motion and second. Any discussion? All in favor, please raise your hand. Opposed? Motion carries.